بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Thank you for the fourth conference of Najaf Denver for giving me this opportunity to talk about the Najaf heritage. Let me say to our guests, welcome in Najaf, welcome in Kufa, welcome in Hayam. This is because in this place there were three important cities which add a lot to the human heritage. The first was a Christian state in the pre-Islam period named Lahmid state, in Arabic Dawlat al-Manadir. It starts from the west bank of Euphrates and extends to the west. The root of this is Hira, the capital of this state, is still in Najaf. It is very close to Najaf airport. To those who come through this airport, they can see this place. It contains a lot of amazing things like this gypsum facade. So it's a piece of the art and the heritage of the human. Later, in the Islamic period, when Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam moved from the Medina, the capital of the Islamic Empire, from Medina to Kufa. Kufa was the capital of this empire, which contains nowadays about 50 countries. Imam Ali governed this very large empire from the mosque of Kufa, and the Kufa was a very important city at that period. The mosque, as you see, was part of the old city and surrounded by old buildings and houses and mosques and so on. But as you see, it's only the mosque and there's empty space surrounding this mosque, because Imam Ali, after death, was buried in a place about 8 kilometers apart from Kufa, which named later as Najaf. And people started from that time to bury their dead people beside this shrine, and the city started to revive more and more. One of the oldest drawings of the city of Najaf, which named Mashhad Ali at the beginning, is this picture, which is drawn or painted by Nasuh Matraqchi. Nasuh Matraqchi is a friend of Sultan Sulaiman al-Qanuni, the Ottoman king, when he came to Iraq and Iran. Nasuh Matraqchi wrote a book named Bayan Manazil al-Iraqayn, and he means that Iraq al-Arab or Iraq al-Ajab. Iraq al-Ajab Medina al-Iraq fi Iran al-Iraq al-Hali. As you see now, this place surrounding the shrine of Imam Ali and the old way of painting. There was an MSc thesis in MIT at 1998 of Kosibai, a researcher. He analyzed this piece and he said that there was mosques and fortress and hammam and bathrooms and so on. Later, Karsten Navur is from Denmark, visited the place, and he documented the city of Najaf. As you see, the shrine of Imam Ali alayhi salam is in the beside the fence of the city. It was very small, but the extension of the city, the buildings, started to grow more and more. And when Miss Bell, at the early ages of the 20th century, she saw Najaf as it is. The shrine is in the middle of the city, and the city is surrounded by this old fence. The city was very important from that, the shrine, that the people want to bury their dead people beside the shrine, but the city started to extend, and the shrine and the cemetery started to shrink. But one of the amazing characteristics of the city is to bring the bodies of the dead people to be buried beside Imam Ali shrine. As you see, this one of the voyagers, John Asher, wrote a book of the people from far from Iraq, 100 kilometers, maybe thousands of kilometers. And the cemetery started to expand more and more from that time. I want to mention also the London News, the issue of 1873, published this very important painting about pilgrims who are coming or were coming to Najaf for the visiting the shrine and at the same time for burying bodies and put them inside the carpets and use a knowledge, a traditional knowledge into doing that. What about the present? I can say now that Najaf is a city of living heritage. Those tradition is continuous. And this, I can say now we have two cities in Najaf. City of the life of the people and also the city of the dead people, Wadi Salam Cemetery, which extended now about 10 kilometers apart from the shrine of Imam Ali. The heritage is related to the human. And so let's ask ourselves, what type of people are interested in heritage of Najaf? I can define four communities have this interest in Najaf. The first are the pilgrims who visited the shrine. Millions of pilgrims are coming for the city every year. And also the pilgrims who are coming to visit the Wadi Salam Cemetery. And a lot of rituals and beliefs are related to those, to this community of people. The Holy Shrine of Imam Ali itself is a part of outstanding monuments in the heritage world. I can say now, this is one of the secrets of this old building. And I hope that you will visit the building during the conference. We have this in the front facade of the shrine. It is built about the polygon. The polygon, I think you notice the golden ratio. Some people name it the sacred ratio. It is 1.618:1. It is a ratio of everything created in this globe. For example, the brain of the human, and also our galaxy. All this is built in the same ratio, 1.618:1. For this, they name it the sacred ratio. The second part of those people who are belong to the heritage of Najaf is the students of religious studies, which name in Arabic Al-Hawza Al-Almiya, or Talabat Al-Hawza Al-Almiya. The same way of study, of research, those round circles of students sitting in a humble way in front of those professors, let me say, or the cleric professors, it continues for 100 years. The places they use it, the mosques, the madrasa schools, are the same and continuous for this, I name this, living heritage. The third community is the workers in this city. This is very important thing and very important characteristic of the city. And it continues the large bazaar, the souq al-kabir in Najaf, continue a lot of traditional things manufactured. For example, one of them, this dressing named Al-Habaa al-Najafiyya, which is, I think it's well known for you because Lionel Messi dressed the Bisht or Al-Habaa, but this is not from Najaf, but it's the same. It is very important. Najaf now export a lot of this Bisht for the Arabic Gulf. And also the manufacturing of by hand for the haga, which is in the head. And also the traditional perfume, al-misk, and so on, inside Najaf. And one of the amazing things manufactured in Najaf, which is type of rings and type of stones named Dur al-Najaf. Dur al-Najaf is a stone inside the desert, beside the Najaf. It is, I think, about 90 to 95% of silica material, so it is a transparent stone. I will finish just a few slides, I'm sorry. A lot of people now write on these stones anything you want. For example, I visited University of Kentucky 10 years ago. There was a deal or a cooperation between functioning of dressing for those students of clerics from Hanafi studies is very important. The fourth community is the people residence in this place. As you see, this city of Najaf is full of life, full of traditions. Those four communities are interact with each other in what I name living heritage of Najaf. And welcome again, University of Kufa and in Najaf, and thank you.